For this patient, he had started with the problem of swelling in the left breast and right breast also, but mainly he had problem with the at the around the age of 11 years he had on and off pain in this region, for which he took some medication. At the commonest starting point for gynecomastia in almost all the patients, in this patient there is a lump in this area which is the breast tissue. Gynecomastia can be of many grades. In some patients it is just the glandular tissue, like him it is more of the glandular tissue, but in many it is glandular tissue as well as the surrounding fat also, which can become enlarged. But for him it is more of a glandular element, and little bit of fatty tissue is also there, which we will remove. We will grow through a very small incision in this area. We will take out both the extra breast, both the breast tissue from the both sides, and whatever fat is there we will take out through this only. Sometimes the fat is too much, that time, and in that cases we need to do special liposuction procedure along with this. But normally with this type of gynecomastia we do not need to do any liposuction, and whatever the small hole through which we are going to remove the complete breast, we don't need even to do the stitching for this. This heals by itself very quickly. We have performed a bilateral gynecomastia repair for this patient. He had relatively smaller lump on the right side, but the bigger one was on the left side. The same is the thing when we have evacuated the complete cavity. This much is the pack which we have introduced. You can see the almost size of a mop can, half a mop can go in this side, and in this area almost complete mop has gone inside. So this much breast tissue we have removed from the left side, and almost a half, near the half mop we have removed from the right side. So once this is done, we have performed everything through very small hole. The surgery is practically dreadless. Around 15 minutes to 30 minutes is the average time to perform this surgery. It took us around 20 minutes on the right side and around 15 to 20 minutes on the left side. But if the size of the breast is bigger, this can take little more time also. So we should not be focusing about the surgery time, but we should be considering the best hemostasis and complete removal of the breast tissue. Now what breast tissue we have removed is, this contains fat and glandular tissue. This fat, when it increases when you gain weight in the breast tissue, the fat size also increases. So whatever type of exercises you do, it is very difficult to lose this type of fat. This will keep accumulating only. The final solution will remain only removal of the breast. Whatever exercise you do, it will act on the pectoralis muscle. You will gain the muscle, and gradually you will realize your breast is increasing more. As you lose your the strength of your muscle, they will become more prominent. And this is very common in the gym goers, those who are doing excessive breast exercise, chest exercise, those who want to make their pectoralis. They do a lot of hard work to remove this gynecomastia, but this never functions. Only thing is they are enlarging their pectoralis muscle. The only thing which you will gain is pectoralis muscles, and as much you increase the size of pectoralis muscle, the more prominent this chest is going to become. So as you lose a little bit of muscle mass, once you stop exercising, even the skin also becomes lax, and you feel, oh, after exercise, once I have stopped doing the gym, this gynecomastia has increased. But actually it is not the case. So unless and until we remove the complete breast, this is going to bother. Either you have to forget it or you have to remove it. These are the only two choices. There are some medical management available in the form of, we do some sort of laser where we can reduce the size of the fat globules, fat cells, and that will lead to some sort of shrinkage in the breast size. But that is all a temporary solution. Permanent solution is removing of the glandular as well as little bit of fat tissue around the breast, which will finally help you achieve the normal shape. Thank you. after gynecomastia surgery. You can see this breast is absolute flat now. You cannot see any scar in this region. Only the person knows that there this has that extra breast has been removed. But otherwise, if you see, you cannot judge it from the far that there is anything, any surgery is being performed. So the best part about this is because we go through the area and we are not taking any proper stitches, just the usual stitches where the stitch marks are there. So whatever we do is from the this subareolar region. Same is with this area also. So we cannot see any evident scars.